Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech, and I wanted to share with you 5 simple iPad tips and tricks that you might not know. And these will apply not only to the iPad Pro that I have here, but any iPad that runs iPadOS, so your iPad Air 2 and newer. And so the first tip has to do with taking a screenshot. There's kind of an interesting way to do that, but if you're not familiar with taking one already, if you have a normal iPad, you can simply press the power sleep wake button and the home button at the same time. Just click them and it will take a screenshot. If you have an iPad Pro like I have here, what you want to do is press volume up and the power sleep wake button at the same time and it will snap a screenshot. However, if you have an Apple Pencil, there's a better way. So maybe you want to take a screenshot of a website. We just drag in from the corner and it will take a screenshot. So you just need to drag in from the corner here and it will take a screenshot. We can do that again. Let me delete this. I'll show you again. Drag in from the corner and it takes a screenshot. Then you can extend it to full page. So maybe you want the full page of a screenshot. Maybe you want to mark this up with an Apple Pencil. Circle this here. You can do that and then you can simply save it. Hit done and then save PDF to files. So you have that ability and it's really nice. You can just do that with the Apple Pencil. Now, the second tip has to do with the keyboard. I get this question a lot and people ask me, how can I use the quick path keyboard or sort of where you swipe around with your finger to type on the keyboard, but on an iPad? So if you're not using any of the accessories with a keyboard or a trackpad, what you want to do is go to say notes or something that uses the keyboard. And all you need to do is pinch and it shrinks the keyboard. Now you have a smaller keyboard where you can just move it around with this little line down here. And then we can say, hi, how are you today? And you can just swipe around to get that written out. So it's really nice. You can extend it like this or press and hold on the keyboard in the bottom right until it says floating. And then we tap on floating and we've got a floating keyboard. So it's really simple, but it's nice that we have that ability. Now, in addition to that, you can also move the cursor around, and you probably already know this if you've had an iPad for a while, but you can move the cursor around using 2 fingers. So you'll see the cursor up here. I'll just move it back and forth using 2 fingers. It becomes a trackpad. So it's really nice. It's a nice way to select text, kind of move the cursor exactly where you want, and then select what you want. So it's a really simple way to do that. Now, there's something else we can do in text that we can use our iPhone with to go back and forth between the iPad. So this is something I actually do quite a lot. So on my iPhone, maybe I'm editing a text document. In fact, this is the same note that I have on the iPad that I just created. Maybe I want to copy this text, but I need it on the iPad and I don't have it there. All we need to do is select the text, maybe copy the whole thing, hit copy. And as long as you're using iCloud on the same account, go back to the iPad and tap, paste, and it will copy from the iPhone over to the iPad. You can do this in reverse. You can do this between an iPad and a Mac. As long as they're on the same iCloud account, Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are turned on, it will just simply drop over to the next device. It's really simple to use. And that goes along with the next thing. Now, something else that we can do between devices is, as long as we're in the same iCloud account again, and that copy and paste works, what you can do is something called handoff. And this is something I use all the time. So maybe I'm reading something on my iPhone and it's a smaller screen and I want to continue reading it on my larger iPad. Maybe I'll go into this website, which is my own website, and I want to open it on the iPad. Well, as soon as I open it, you may have noticed this icon appear in the dock on the iPad. I simply go to the iPad, tap on the dock here, and it opens up right where I was before. Now, this works in multiple apps. So this could work in Notes. It can work in anything you're working on your iPhone. It goes back and forth. A lot of people aren't familiar with that, but it's something that I use all of the time. Now, something else that's really interesting that is actually new to me when I was researching for this video, I hadn't seen before, is something that you can do with Siri, or you could type it in as well. But we can play radio stations on the iPhone and iPad. Now, for example, if you're in your car and maybe you're traveling to and from work and you want to continue listening to whatever you were listening to in the car on the radio, you can continue to listen to that through the iPad or the iPhone. It's pretty simple. You just need to ask Siri. Now, you will need to know the call letters and the channel or station numbers so that you can tell it what to play. But as long as you have that, you're good to go. So for example, I'm in the Charlotte, North Carolina area. I just did a simple search for radio stations and I'm just picking one randomly. So let's go ahead and try this. Play WKQC 104.7 radio. and now it will play. And you'll see it says from iHeartRadio. I don't have iHeartRadio installed, so it will play either way. If I hit open iHeartRadio, it will play either way. So as long as you ask Siri to play it and it's available, you'll be able to continue listening to your radio station on your iPad or your iPhone. Now, if you have an iPad that you're using with a keyboard, such as this Magic Keyboard, or maybe you're just using any keyboard of your choice, there's a shortcut that I use all of the time on not only the iPad, but also a Mac as well. So it's Spotlight Search, and it allows you to do a lot more than you think. So if you hold Command and hit Space, it brings up Search, and maybe you want to open an app. You don't know where it is on your iPad. All you need to do is maybe type App Store, hit Return. It'll bring you to the App Store. Maybe we'll type Safari. It will bring you to Safari. And you don't really need to type the whole thing. You can type just SAF, hit enter, and you're in. So I use this for all sorts of things all the time. And you can even use it for things like math. So 4 plus 4, and it gives you the answer right there. So it's a really simple way to use your iPad. It's a very fast way to navigate around. And if you're used to using it on the Mac, it translates very well here. And maybe you're looking for other keyboard shortcuts, just hold Command and it will give you the keyboard shortcuts for the screen you're on. So hopefully those iPad tips and tricks were helpful and new to you. If they were, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And of course, if you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, I'll link it in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.